It is November Bladder Health Month, and in honor of that, I'm going to be talking about the weird things that your bladder does that you probably don't know about. I'm Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and if you're new here, we talk about bladder health, urologic health, sexual health, and so much more. If you like what you see, make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss my new videos every week. First off, you know, your bladder can spasm. What does that mean? Well, you can have contractions of your bladder when you're not ready for them. Those are typically called urge, right? You get an urge to go and you can't delay, the sudden strong desire, and it's usually accompanied by a bladder contraction or what we call a bladder spasm. Interestingly, for some people, when they spasm their bladder, they don't get an urge. They actually get a pain at the tip of their penis. So for men, they'll get a pain at the tip of their penis, and for women, sometimes they'll get a pain at the tip of their clitoris or in their vaginal area. And it can be pretty confusing because you're like, I'm not sure why I'm having this really weird pain that's kind of far away from my bladder. And then they come to see urologists and we'll often give them a medication that can help relax bladder spasms and that pain will go away. So in the same vein, another weird thing that our bladders do is that they can squeeze too hard or too little. And what do I mean by that? Well, if they squeeze too hard, you get what's called overactive bladder, which means that these normal sensations that we all get, the gotta go sensation that happens to everybody, becomes more and more common. So you get a lot more urgency. And sometimes that can cause your bladder to squeeze before it's ready and have contractions. And that can sometimes cause you to have leakage. And specifically, this type of incontinence is called urgency urinary incontinence. It's leakage that occurs when your bladder squeezes before you're ready for it to happen and causes leakage. So leakage that's associated with a sudden desire to rush to the bathroom that you can't hold off. And what about squeezing too little? Well, in some people, because of neurologic injuries, because they have held their bladder for many, many years over a long period of time, because they have a large prostate or some other reason that's blocking urine flow, or if they have diseases like diabetes, their bladder can get weak over time. And what does that mean? Well, that can mean that when you're trying to empty your bladder, the bladder just doesn't squeeze as well as it used to when you were younger. And that means that you'll squeeze urine out and you'll feel like you're empty, but it won't completely empty. And so you may or may not know that some people will perceive that they feel like something's left inside. Others will just say, hey, I have to go back pretty soon right afterwards, so I feel like I didn't empty completely. But sometimes you won't know it at all. And is this a problem? Well, it really depends. Some people can walk around with an incompletely emptied bladder without a problem at all. Other people will start having a lot of frequency, like needing to go to the bathroom a lot during the day or waking up at night. And some people will start getting recurrent urinary tract infections or bladder infections because that urine that sits around is like food for bacteria. And bacteria come and eat up all that food and cause you to have recurrent infections in your bladder. And I know all of you are probably wondering, well, how can I prevent it? Well, if you have certain conditions like diabetes, make sure that you take very good control of your sugar and also don't hold your urine all the time. Holding it once in a while is fine, but if you hold it all the time for years and years and years, which we often see in people like nurses, doctors, teachers, hairdressers, truck drivers, people who just can't get to a bathroom because they're too busy taking care of somebody or something, they have a harder time getting to the bathroom and suddenly develop these kind of what we call dysfunctional behaviors. Like they'll keep holding their bladder for hours and hours and hours, and their bladder gets used to holding that much. But as it stretches out, sometimes it can get weaker and the squeeze of the bladder can get weak. And some things are somewhat out of your control. You can't really do anything to decrease the growth of your prostate, and you can't really do anything to reverse certain neurologic problems. At least not yet. Another interesting thing about your bladder is for some people, it can hold a lot. And for some people, it can hold a little. In fact, when you look at data of people who've gotten their capacity or the amount of urine they can hold in their bladder checked, the average is about 12 to 14 ounces or 350 to 400 milliliters. But if you look at the whole spectrum of people, it can range from anywhere from 110 mLs, which is a little over 3 ounces, to almost 700 mLs, which is well over 20 ounces. So that's quite a bit. The next interesting thing or weird thing about your bladder is it's sensitive. So there are certain things that can really irritate or inflame your bladder. Check out my video on bladder irritants where I go over this in a lot of detail, but essentially things like caffeine, alcohol, for some people spicy foods, artificial sweeteners, fruit juices or highly acidic foods, tomato-based products, those things can all irritate the bladder lining and make you feel like you gotta go, or maybe even make you feel like you have some discomfort in the bladder itself. Also, it's extremely sensitive to smoking. So if you smoke, you will notice that you're probably having a little bit more often trips to the bathroom, and smoking is a risk for bladder cancer. So if you are smoking, this is the one thing that you could absolutely change to help prevent you from getting something as dangerous as bladder cancer. Bladder cancer is not a fun disease. If you get bladder cancer, having your bladder taken out is no small surgery. It is a big, major, life-changing surgery, and it might require you having a bag on the outside where you urinate into. If you don't get your bladder taken out, the other options for treatment are very time intensive. You have to come to the office, get treatments inside your bladder, and get lots of cystoscopies where we look in the bladder routinely to check if there's any recurrence of bladder cancer. It's not a small thing, so please quit smoking today. The next interesting thing about the bladder is that when your bladder fills, if you can't empty your bladder for whatever reason, whether it's because you've developed a cause of urinary retention, like having a large prostate in men, you've recently had surgery and you stopped being able to urinate, you've had some neurologic injury to the bladder, or you've had long-standing diabetes, as I mentioned, and you can't empty your bladder for long periods of time, many, many months, the urine can then start backing up into your kidneys, called hydronephrosis. And that's because if you look at the anatomy, the kidneys have these little tubes called the ureters that go down and connect into the bladder. Usually the bladder is flexible like a balloon, and so it fills and fills and fills, and it can fill quite a bit and it doesn't cause any increased pressure. But in some cases, the pressure just becomes too much, and that pressure either causes you to start leaking down below or it has to go up into the kidneys. If that happens, you can have kidney failure, which is also a very serious condition. So if you're having issues emptying your bladder, make sure you see a urologist right away to make sure that your kidneys are safe. All right, and the last thing is, can you really burst your bladder, right? If you drink a ton, and you're like, oh my God, my bladder is gonna burst, is it really gonna happen? Well, the short answer is yes, you can burst your bladder, but it is extremely rare. There are very few cases of spontaneous bladder rupture, usually because of underlying infection, having a recent surgery on your bladder, or a couple cases have been reported in patients who were cognitively impaired or not all there because they were drunk with alcohol consumption or due to having previous radiation therapy on the bladder. So if you're a normal, healthy person, your body will normally kick in and you will end up having to go to the bathroom and you won't be able to rupture your bladder. That being said, I wouldn't try to figure it out at home. Drink normally, go to the bathroom when you feel the urge, and don't hold your urine. All right, so in honor of Bladder Health Month, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please check out a lot more information about Bladder Health Month on the Urology Care Foundation website. I will link it down below. It's urologyhealth.org, and they do a great job educating you on all things about your bladder. As always, remember to take care of yourself because you're worth it.